Welcome and thank you so much for joining me today. So we are going to be looking at adding and subtracting serves. Now, I just want you to think about what we did with algebra. If we're adding apples and apples, we can say I've got two apples, 2A, and I'm adding 3A, three apples. I just don't know the price. I'm told I'm getting 5A, five apples. So when we are talking about the same thing, we can add them together. When we're not, it makes it a bit trickier. So to start off, 2 times square root of 3 plus 4 times the square root of 3, our variable, which is square root of 3, is the same. So I can add them together. I can go, well, I've got 2 lots of this and I've got 4 lots of this. How many do I have in total? I've got 6 lots. So I've got 6 lots of square root of 3. And that's just what I'd like you to think about, because it comes back to our multiplication. So if I've got 4 times 5 equals 20, I could easily write that as I've got 2 lots of 5 and I've got 2 lots of 5. If I've got 2 lots of 5, 2 plus 2 is 4. 4 times 5 equals 20, and that's the same. 2 times 5 is 10. 10 plus 10 equals 20. So I want you to think of it as in terms of lots. Let's drop that out. Okay. Next thing, we go over here. We are looking at what is the same, what is a like term. So let's have a look. I know here I've got root 6 and I've got root 6 here. Then I've got root 2 and root 2. So all it's saying is I've got 4 lots of root 6 and I'm taking away 3 lots of root 6. I'll only have 1 lot of root 6 left. So I could write it as 1 root 6, but 1 times root 6 is just going to be root 6. Then I can look at my next part. I've got 3 lots of root 2 and I'm adding 2 more lots of root 2. 3 plus 2 equals 5. 5 root 2. And that, there you have it, that we have just simplified our equation. Okay, now when they are different, we need to simplify and try and get it to be the same term. So, and that means thinking about this here, which is 8, square root of 8. Using our rule, we can say the square root of something, say xy, is the same as me doing square root of x times the square root of y. So that applies here. What are two numbers that times together to equal 8? And we're thinking about square numbers. So 4 is a square number. I'd like to use 4. So here, I'm doing the square root of 4 times the square root of 2. And I'm trying to get the same variable. If we're the same variable, it means we can simplify after when we're adding or take away. So square root of 4 is 2. So that gives me, take 2, the square root of 2. So if I've got 5 lots of square roots of 2, and I'm taking 2 lots of the square roots of 2 away, 5 take away 2 is 3. 3 square root 2. Let's go to another similar problem. Here again, I've got nothing in like that's a like term. I know that this is 5 and I won't be able to do anything with that, so that will be my term that I'm looking for. 2 square root 5. So I've got 3 times, I want a square root 5 here. 5 times what equals 20? 5 times 4. So that means I'll have a square root of 4. Plus 6 times, again, I want a square root of 5, so I've got a like term. 5 times what equals 45? 5 times 9. So times the square root of 9. Now I can simplify. I've got 2 square root of 5. Take. Now, I've got here 3 times the square root of 4 is 2 times the square root of 5. plus, I've got 6, square root of 9 is 3, so it's times 3 times square root of 5. Now, let's try and simplify this a bit more. I'm going to change colours, so that way it's easier for you to see. So I've got 2 square root of 5, 2 times 3 is 6, so it's 6 square root 5, plus 6 times 3, 6, 12, 18, square root 5. And there you have it. So, this is the stage that we're up to now, and now we just need to simplify. Because each of them, I've got the same like term. So we've got 2 lots of square root of 5, and I take 6 away. That becomes negative 4 square root of 4. If I've got negative 4, I'm adding 18. It turns into, I've got 14 lots of square root 5. And there you have it. So just like algebra, when we're doing certs, we can think about it as like terms.